Because I wanted to hear your voices. I wanted you to write about things that mattered. I wanted you to think about rhetoric in a way that was experiential instead of theoretical. And some things went well with that. I have distinct assignment types that I must do as a professor. And so I have attempted to do those, only they're in ways that I've never done them before. The closest that comes to being the same is the research essay, and even that is different. And so, you know, like some things went well and some things didn't went well. What I could do and what I did do is you got a lot of points for participating in group discussions, whether it was a group discussion, because I wanted you to learn, and I didn't want, you know, like my my experimentation to hurt your grade. I wanted you to learn and to for your grade to reflect your learning, because I know that I know how to teach. It's just I'm trying different strategies. And so I included a lot of points, every single one of those reflection direction essay, you know, like, I think we had like, oh, I don't know, including the essay reflections, but yeah, that was 100 points there. And the discussion boards, those were lots of points, and peer review, those were lots of points. And so you got a lot of points for participating in the class. And I created rubrics to privilege or emphasize some types of things, the things that I thought were most important. And so I suspect that if you've done everything in this class, you'll be pretty happy with your grade. There are always more B's than A's and always more B's than C's. But I suspect that there will be fewer C's and more A's than normal. So just because anytime I experiment, I give students the benefit of the doubt. So this is the beginning of the end. It's always awkward. I want to discuss the final essay. It's due December 16. I apologize profusely for putting December 9 there. It's because my Southwestern class, everything is due on December 9, which is Wednesday, but I fully intended for you to have up to a week and a half to do this essay. And yeah, I was like, dang, no wonder they looked so intense last Monday. I wanna look at the rubric today, and I wanted to discuss the status of the book and more extra credit opportunities. This is our last synchronous class, which makes me really sad and excited at the same time, because this has been a crazy semester. You all know it's been a crazy semester. And so what we're doing on Wednesday is, what I'm doing on Wednesday is I'm just gonna be in my office. You don't have to make an appointment. You just pop in. It has to be my office, not the classroom. I can look at your paper. You can just drop in to say goodbye or hi. But I can look at your research paper, because I know some of you are still working on that. You can turn it in all the way to the 12th. There is no penalty. I've tried to be as flexible as I can with due dates and still not make myself crazy. Because if there's never a due date, then I never finish anything. And then my anxiety kicks in really badly. And then I'm not a nice person. So being nice it's just that mutual respect that we have. So December 12th is the last day. I can look at your research paper. I can look at your final essay, or we can just talk. It doesn't matter. I'll just sit there and have it open on one of my screens. And that's that. we started this semester with a pandemic, multiple lockdowns, some of you got sick. I have been incredibly grateful for your participation in class, for your participation in the groups, and your attention to revision and details. I know I give you, like I've been insistent on showing and not just telling. I talk about pink houses and fruit jello and the importance of paragraphs. And I appreciate that you're absorbing all these things. I hope you see the connections between all the random stuff I talk about and how it's valuable in all kinds of writing, whether it's writing for this class or another class, whether you're writing for an audience of academics or you're writing for an audience of your peers. I also wanted to give you an opportunity to say something that matters. I didn't always do that in my classes, and I really sucked. I was part of that machine that sucks the life out of writing and makes students hate to write. And a few years ago, I said, I don't want to do that anymore. Writing matters, and you have something to say. And yes, you have to do the academic writing. I can't take that away. But I can say, here's what that looks like. And here's how it's the same as when, you know, like you're saying something that matters. Our writing changes depending on audience and purpose. I quote E. Shelley Reid incessantly. I hope that she haunts you in all of your writing classes from now till the end of time. I do not apologize for that. I started out with this idea of project-based learning. It's been messy. This is my first experiment with this. We will have these books. I had to figure out how to get copyright permissions from all of you and honor FERPA, which is a federal law. So don't forget to sign permissions or to say, yeah, count me out. You get points either way. So please do that. I will, if you've said in an email, hey, yeah, I think I'd like my research paper in this book, I'm excited to include it. I've seen some of your research papers and I love your willingness to jump into this very academic discussion, but to make it real by making it connected to your own learning process. And I think that that's value in any discussion on literacy and literacy education. So if you've said, I think I want that to go out, I will send you a new permission slip that you'll need to sign that I can include that. I need original images for the cover. And if you say, no, I really want some extra credit, so I'm willing to help with formatting. I want this to be done by next Wednesday, the 16th, so that I can send you links so we can have it available. I may introduce it to some colleagues. It didn't turn out quite the way I wanted because I'm learning. So, you know, watch for extra credit because it's out there. We all deserve extra credit this semester because it's just been that kind of semester. So watch for that whenever you see an announcement come out from me. I am super, super grateful for all of you. And your willingness to allow me to learn through an experiment with this class. And I told you, ending a class is always awkward. I've read some of the best work ever from this class. And I feel privileged to be your instructor this semester. The other thing I want to say is we do hire in the Writing Center. It is a job. All those tutors are paid, and they're paid pretty well. I think maybe not as well as In-N-Out, but I think we start them at maybe $14.25 an hour. Might be $13.75, and then they get a raise. I don't know. I don't keep up with that. We don't hire for spring. We hire for fall. We don't hire a lot of second years, but we do, with second years, we do privilege the ones that come from the 220 class because you are more familiar with writing centers than any other second years. We hired two students from, well, currently we have six students who are from my 220 classes working in the Writing Center. And two of them were in the class last fall. I would have hired more, but they didn't apply. And I was excited to learn that some of them became tutors in other contexts. And some of them are advisors. Honestly, if you've been in the Writing Center, especially if you've been in more than those two required times, you've gotten a feel for tutoring, and that's valuable to us. I could randomly talk about stuff for six more minutes, but really there is no point. So I'll let you go early. Come drop in if you want me to look at your work on Wednesday. It's the last office hours I've got. No need to make an appointment. Although some of you did make appointments, I will honor those appointments and I will set it up so nobody can just randomly drop in with those. I know, Amaru, you have an appointment on Wednesday. Mari, I think, I can't remember who has them and who doesn't. So if you have an appointment, I honor those appointments. Otherwise, I'll just be sitting in there from 11 to 2 talking to you. So if you have questions you want to ask or anything that we didn't say from your groups and you want to add that to my list of things I should remember for spring, I really do appreciate that. So you can be dismissed if you want, or you can stick around. I'm not going anywhere.
Thank you. I really enjoyed it so much, Professor.
Thank you, Professor.
Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you, Professor.
I'll see you on Wednesday, Derek. Thank you, Connor.